If you want to import and export examinations, you can do this using two different file formats. The E2E format is a proprietary Heidelberg Engineering format and is suitable if you export, for example, Spectralis examinations, which are imported into HIEX version 1. The DICOM format, on the other hand, is an international standard format for medical imaging data and allows the data to be viewed using any DICOM-capable software, including HIEX 2. The transfer of Anterion data is only possible in the DICOM format. To import an examination, go to the Import tab. Click E2E to import E2E files, then navigate to the desired storage location and select the E2E file or files for import. We cancel the import as a DICOM file is to be imported in our example. Therefore, click Drive, navigate to the desired storage location and select the DICOM DIR file for import. The import window displays an overview of the patient and examination data to be imported. You can use plus and minus to open and close the tree structure to select or deselect individual examinations that are to be imported or not imported. To choose several files, hold the control key while selecting. All data to be imported are now highlighted in yellow. You can then choose from several import options. Click Import to import the data directly. If the master data to be imported matches exactly a data record in your database, it is automatically assigned to the subject. In our example, we want to assign the data manually to a patient who already exists in the system. This is recommended, for example, if a different patient ID is stored in your system. Click Import and Assign to assign the data to a patient. HIEX compares the data to be imported with the data already available in HIEX. If a patient with similar master data already exists, they will be suggested for selection. If the desired patient is not listed, click Manual Search for Patients. Enter the last name in the field and start the fuzzy search by pressing the Enter key. Then select the desired subject and click Import to assign the data. The import progress can be tracked in the status bar. After the import, the data can be found in the patient list as usual and filtered accordingly. For example, if you only want to display the data imported today, go back to the Review tab and select the Received Today option from the Time drop-down list. You will now only see people whose data was fully or partially imported on this day. If you would like to export data, we recommend saving the export file locally on your computer first and then copying it from there to a storage medium such as a USB stick or CD. To do this, first create a target folder, example on the desktop. Back in HIEX 2, go to the Export tab in the action bar. For Spectralis acquisitions, you can choose whether the data is to be exported in E2E or DICOM format. If there is an Anterion acquisition within the export dataset, it can only be exported as a DICOM file. In the Templates area, you will find various predefined export templates. In a first step, the data can be collected in the order to be exported together. To export the original data, select DICOM, uncompressed, or E2E. To minimize the data size, you can alternatively use the DICOM compressed template. To export the data anonymously, use DICOM anonymized or E2E anonymized. In this case, the name and ID are automatically replaced by an anonymous patient or anonymous and a random number combination. If you would like to manually anonymize or pseudo-anonymize the data, use the DICOM or E2E Anonymize and Rename or DICOM or E2E Study Anonymize template for export. Select the patient, examination or acquisition to be exported, and drag and drop the desired entries onto the export template symbol. As soon as data has been added to the template, the icon turns blue. Double-click on the template to see which data has already been saved. You can also remove entries where they were added by mistake by selecting the relevant data and clicking Delete Selected Items. If the template now contains all the data to be exported, close the window with Close and drag the export template symbol to the desired destination drive. If you have not created a folder for the data to be exported, add one by clicking Make New Folder. If you already have a destination folder, navigate to the storage location and click OK to start the export. In the export window, you can now see the export progress. As soon as Finished Successfully appears, the export is completed and the window can be closed. The exported data is now stored in the selected folder and can be copied to a storage medium of your choice. In contrast to the single E2E file, the DICOM export is divided into three related elements, two folders and a DICOM DIR file. If you want to copy the data to a storage medium of your choice, you must always copy the complete package consisting of the two folders and the DICOM DIR file. You should also ensure that there is only one DICOM export package in each folder and that a separate folder is created for each export.